This is my 2004 Sportsman 500 HO, and I'm going to do the clutch cover seal that's on the back side of the clutch cover against the engine. The seal went bad, getting water into the clutches anytime you go through any kind of puddle, and the belt slips. So I'm going to do a little video on how to do it. There'll be some time lapse, basic stuff, taking everything apart, getting down to it, and then we'll change the seal out and see how it goes. Okay, so once you get your belt cover off, like you would if you were just changing your belt, you can take these bolts out. So the bolt sizes, all the heads of the bolts, this is a half inch on the secondary. Pop that out of there. Got 5/8 on the primary. Pull that out. Got a little spacer on there. Keep that all together. We got our puller. I'm gonna put a little bit of grease on that and pop that off. Okay, we got a little bit of grease on the puller there. Wax comes right off, no problem. All right, get this out of the way. We'll take a look at that seal. Okay, we got a couple bolts here. We got a 3/8 head on them. Take these out. Looks like we got 5 of them. They do have washers on them. Some kind of rubber washer. I hope I'm not ruining them by taking them out. Okay, then we got 3 Phillips head screws right there. And easy. And here is our bad seal. Sorry about that. You can see where that seal, we lost half of that seal. It's just dry rotted. So we should be able to pull this, yep, there we go, pull that whole cover right off. And you can see where that seal just fell apart. Just dry rotted. It's 04 Sportsman 500 HO. So we'll clean this cover up. Maybe glue that back down, that seal there. Clean the clutches out and then come back and install a seal. There's the Polaris part number. Pretty big seal. It's actually marked on here too. This side towards engine, so you can't put it in the wrong way. I'm curious, there's a little bit of silicone on here from the factory. This has never been a part. I've owned this quad since new. So I'm thinking I might peel this off and lay down a new bead. We'll see how that goes. Okay, I did not remove the silicone. I'm gonna leave it on there, just how it is, because it definitely wasn't stuck to the seal. It's like they use it as an extra step for sealing. So I'm going to leave that there. But I am going to use some Scotch-Brite. Just clean up this surface where the seal sits. But it's not the greatest. I think I'll soap and water that a little bit too. Get it nice and cleaned up. Alright, so I cleaned up the crankcase right there. Washed it up, dried it off. This is the rear seal here on the trans. I probably should have gotten one of those too. Maybe next time. So I'll slip this back on. In here. Yeah, I'm gonna add a little bit of silicone. These bolts that go into the trans have a rubber washer. They're kind of falling apart here. So I'm gonna put a dab of silicone around each one and put them back in. See what happens. Alright, a little silicone behind all those. I had to chase the threads on this one. New seal is in. Over the lip on here. The retainer back on there. Should be good to go. Okay, got the retainer back in place. Three Phillips head screws. It's nice in there. Nice and clean in here now. Got that silicone on those bolts. Those rubber washers weren't looking too hot. And next I'm going to go clean the clutches out good, inspect the clutches, and then we'll get it put back together. Alright, just going to put everything back together here. Primary. A little spacer in there. For this one. There we go. Can't believe how small that bolt is that holds on that secondary. It's like a 5/16 bolt. Tighten these up, throw the belt on it, and fire it up. Make sure everything works here. So, pretty easy job. Everything came apart good for me. I guess if that clutch wouldn't have came off, we could have had some issues. But, all back together. No more water in the belt box. Got some new tires for it. Bear claws. Buy those because they're cheap and they're good. Yeah, this seal is, again, this is a 2004. This has never been done before. I'm the original owner. And this seal is just dry rotted. It is just, it's brittle. It would probably break if I tried to break her air. But that should keep us nice and dry in the belt box for a while. Thanks.